Supreme Court ruling, the Commission on Elections committed grave abuse of discretion when it disqualified Smartmatic from bidding in the 2025 polls. Adrian Ayaleen now joins us with the details of this story. Go ahead, Adrian.
Yes, Stanley, the Supreme Court has granted the petition filed by Smartmatic against the Commission on Elections on its disqualification to bid for the 2025 election. In the decision of the court promulgated on April 16, 2024, here in Baguio City, however, the contract awarded by VCOMELEC to Miru Systems was not nullified. The court cited considerations of equity, justice, practicality, and the doctrine of operative fact in the decision penned by Associate Justice Jose Maidas Marquez. The SE noted that the case started when Smartmatic received an invitation from COMELEC to attend the election and procurement summit for the 2025 elections. Private respondents then filed petitions against Smartmatic before the COMELEC and bank, which ended with the commission disqualifying Smartmatic from participating in the bidding. Smartmatic then filed its petition before the SE. The SE emphasized in its decision that it granted the petition of Smartmatic because the COMELEC committed grave abuse of discretion when it disqualified Smartmatic before it had submitted any bid without any reference to the eligibility requirements prescribed by its bids and awards committee. Asked during a media briefing here in Baguio City, SE spokesperson Attorney Camille Ting said Smartmatic did not suffer irreparable injury because the injury would have just been loss of profits and there are legal remedies that the company can take. In a statement, Smartmatic said it was vindicated by the Supreme Court decision and it is ready to explore further opportunities to contribute to the modernization of Philippine elections. Back to you, Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Adrian Ayaleen. A Philippine lawmaker amplifies calls for a House probe on the gentleman's agreement between the Duterte administration and China. Zambales Representative Jay Kong-hoon says with his constituents experiencing China's harassment firsthand, it is vital to know the details of the supposed deal. He adds the country's credibility, territorial integrity, and economic well-being are all at stake if details of the agreement won't be revealed.
Kailangan iisang boses lang tayo, no? Lalong-lalo na sa pakikipag-usap sa China. Pero tandaan din natin, no? Kailangan makita natin kung ano ba talaga na pag-usapan. Kailangan siguraduhin natin na ano, na meron tayong credibility sa pakikipag-usap sa ibang bansa. Baka naman mamaya, hindi na tayo paniwalaan dahil iba ang sinasabi ng China, iba ang sinasabi ng ating dating Pangulo. No?
Kong-hoon adds the lower chamber will set the timeline for the inquiry once Congress resumes its sessions on April 29. Telco giant Globe warning the public against clicking links sent to them via text messages amid a rise in so-called spoofing. The scheme, the firm says, is run by scammers posing as network companies to access their credit card details and other sensitive information.
Ang nangyayari po, gumagamit po sila ng makina na tinatawag po IMSI-catcher. Nag-impersonate ng cell tower. Yung mga scammer, like nasa backpack nila yan o nasa loob ng mga van, umiikot po sila. Tapos nun, ang radius niyan, ang lahat ng mga cellphone na malapit dun sa van, kukunek po dun yung mga cellphone. Pag kumunek po yung cellphone dun, kahit anong sender po, pwede na nilang ispoof. Pwede po nilang gawin ang sender Globe. Wala na po kaming ipapadalang mensahe. Kahit na official message ng Globe, wala na pong link yan.